So good afternoon students. Today we are going to study about keyboard interfacing in microcontroller case. So keyboard interfacing in microcontroller case is there are two approaches in interfacing the keyboard to the microcontroller or the microprocessor. One is a hardware approach and another one is a software approach. One is a hardware approach and another one is a software approach. Hardware approach is nothing but which we have studied in microprocessor case during the third unit, during the third semester. So there we studied about one IC called as a 8279. So the 8279 is acting as a, it is used for interfacing the keyboard as well as the display using the hardware approach to the microprocessor or the microcontroller. You can use the 8279 as a mediator. So when you are using the 8279, then it is called as a hardware approach. So you are not going to interface your matrix keyboard to the microprocessor or microcontroller directly. There you are going to use the 8279 as a mediator. So when you are taking the 8279 as a mediator, there is an advantage for the developer. That advantage is nothing but the 8279 is a one, means we are going to write a simple program to the 8279 in such a way that which is going to be recognized the pressed keys and stores the pressed key information inside the memory which is available in the 8279. And the pressed key information is going to be stored inside the memory as well as the information is going to be transferred to the microprocessor or the microcontroller to which you interface with the, interface the 8279. So that is the hardware approach. But when you are going with the hardware approach, sometimes the cost of the system may be increasing as one more IC is increasing, and as well as the complexity, that is the space occupied by the kit may be means the number of ICs which are integrated on the board is, if it is increasing, then obviously the size of the board may be increases. There are some factors which we, because of which we are not interested to use the hardware approach. Sometimes we are going with the software approach. Software approach means directly we are interfacing our keyboard to the microcontroller or the microprocessor. So when you are interfacing the keyboard to the microcontroller or microprocessor, you are supposed to arrange the keys on the keyboard in the matrix format. You are supposed to arrange the keys in the keys on the keyboard in the matrix format. So when you are taking the matrix format, obviously we know that we are having the rows as well as the columns. We are having the rows as well as the columns. In this class, we are going to study about how to interface the 4x4 matrix keyboard to the microcontroller using the software approach. How to interface 4x4 matrix to the matrix keyboard to the microcontroller using the software approach. So as we are having the 4x4, total number of keys are, keys are going to be 16. So I'm assuming that those keys are indicating the hexadecimal digits. Those keys are indicating the hexadecimal digits. Okay. So now, when you are going for interfacing the matrix keyboard to the microcontroller, as I said, the keys are going to be arranged in the rows and columns format. Keys are going to be arranged in the rows and columns format. In my case, it is a 4x4 matrix now. So we studied about how exactly the rows are going to be differentiated from the columns. We studied in the third semester, but we don't have the board. I can't draw that entire thing again, but I'm going to use the slide. Okay, with the help of the slide, I'm going to explain that particular part. Okay, so with the help of the slide, I'm going to explain that particular part. Yeah. So over here, I'm trying to interface my 4x4 matrix keyboard to the microcontroller. Here we are using the, as per textbook diagram, it is a PIC16F877. If you want, you can replace the 877 with any 8051 microcontroller or the 1661 or the 711 family. It is up to you which microcontroller you are using, but as per the textbook, I am just going with the PIC16F877 microcontroller. Okay, so here what we are interested, in the 4x4 matrix keyboard now. So I'm just using the 4x4 matrix keyboard. So in this case, I'm having the four columns, 1, 2, 3, 4, and four rows, 1, 2, 3, 4. So it is up to you how you are going to assign the numbers to the keys available on the matrix keyboard. How you are going to assign the numbers to the keys which are there on the keyboard. It is up to you. While writing the program, you can decide that one. Okay. But as per this diagram, we are assuming that the columns are indicating the serial numbers 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, AB, C, D, E, F. So like this, the means the keys are going to be assigned with the numerical values depending on our construction. Okay, now depending our on our connections, we are assigning these numbers to the respective keys. Okay, so now Here, these columns are interfaced with the what is that port to B. So here, what we are doing is we are using the 4x4 matrix keyboard. Now, so as we are using the 4x4 matrix keyboard, I'm assuming that the 4 means 4x4 means how many lines we require for the rows and columns. 4 lines for the rows and 4 lines for the columns. So commonly 8 lines we require. 8 I/O lines we require to interface this particular 4x4 matrix to the matrix keyboard to the microcontroller. So here what I'm doing is in from the PIC microcontroller, I'm taking the port to B as a input output lines. Or I can say that the port to B is a 8-bit line. So those 8-bit lines are grouped into two nibbles, one is the high nibble as well as the lower nibble. I'm assuming that the higher nibble of the port to B is connected to the columns of the my matrix keyboard, and lower nibble of the lower nibble is nothing but RB0 to RB3. They are used as the rows to this particular matrix keyboard. Means the higher nibble of the port to B is acting as a columns, lower nibble of the port to B is acting as a rows. Now, when you would like to know means which key has been pressed on the keyboard, you are supposed to write the program, right? You are supposed to write the program. So the problem with the software approach is you are supposed to keep on monitor the columns. Columns is nothing but when you are going to interface the matrix keyboard to the microcontroller, you are going to come across the two terminologies. One is called as a return lines and the next one is called as a scan lines. One is called as a return lines, another one is called as a scan lines. Return lines are nothing but which are acting as a input lines to the microcontroller. Scan lines are nothing but which are acting as the output lines from the microcontroller to the keyboard. So I'm assuming that the return lines in case of the matrix keyboard, return lines are nothing but the columns, and the scan lines are nothing but the rows. Return lines are nothing but the columns, scan lines are nothing but the rows. As I said, return lines are nothing but we should configure those lines as a input lines to the microcontroller. Scan lines are nothing but we should configure those lines as a output lines. One is the return lines, another one is the scan lines. So here, as we are using the port to B to connect the 4x4 matrix keyboard to the PIC microcontroller, what I'm doing is I'm using the higher nibble of the port to B as a return lines. And lower nibble of the port to B is as scan lines. One is the return lines, another one is the scan lines. But we know that return lines are nothing but the input lines. Now, if you want to configure these lines as the input lines, we have a rule that you should write the binary ones on this particular 4 bits. Higher nibble of the port B should be written with the 4 ones, so that they are configured as the input lines. If you want to make these lines as the output lines, you should write the binary zeros on these particular 4 bits. But you can't write the binary zeros, the binary ones onto the respective port B lines to configure them as the input output lines, because it is not the case of 8051. In case of the 8051, directly you can write the binary zeros and binary ones to configure one of the port lines as the input line as well as the output line. But it is not the case, it is not possible in the PIC microcontroller, because in the PIC microcontroller, the direction control means in order to decide the direction of the port, there are the direction control registers for the each and every port which is there in the PIC microcontroller. So in case of the PIC 16F877, we are having the 5 ports, port A, port B, port C, port D, port E. And in order to configure one of the port as an input or output port, you should focus on the respective direction control registers. For the port A, we know that the direction control register is nothing but the TRISK, which is a TRISHA. Okay, now, so to remember that particular direction control register, I defined it as a TRISHA in the class during the classroom, so that you can remember for a long time. And the direction control register for the port B is a TRISB. So TRISB is a 8-bit register. In that 8-bit register, higher nibble should be written as a 1 and the lower nibble of that particular 8-bit register should be written as a 0, so that those lines are configured as a return lines as well as a scan lines. Return lines are nothing but the input lines, scan lines are nothing but the output lines. Means you are supposed to write the in the higher nibble position of the TRISB register as a 1s, in the lower nibble position of the TRISB register as a 0s, so that those lines are configured as a return lines as well as a scan lines. Okay, so this is a way of interfacing our matrix keyboard to the microcontroller. Now the question comes that how the microcontroller is going to be recognize the pressed key. and what logic we are supposed to write, means what logic we are supposed to use in writing the program so that the microcontroller is going to be recognizes our pressed key, which is pressed on the keyboard, So for that, what we are supposed to do means we are supposed to focus on scan lines as well as the return lines. How we are going to make use of the return lines to identify the pressed key as well as the scan lines. Okay. So let us suppose, initially I'm assuming that there is no key pressed on the keyboard. So as I said that whenever we are not pressing any key on the keyboard, we took one condition that the column should act as a input lines. So means if one is pressed on this particular keyboard, means no key is pressed on this particular keyboard, obviously these four bits are going to be indicates its status as a binary ones. Because we configure these lines as an input lines. Input lines are nothing but the binary ones. And we configure these lines as the output lines. Output lines are nothing but the binary zeros. Okay. When we are not pressing any key on the keyboard, obviously there is no contact between the column and the row. If you see this one, push button is connected. It is connected to make the connection between the column and the row. When no key is pressed on the keyboard, obviously there is no chance of shorting the column with the row. Okay, so that's why these input lines should means input lines are nothing but the return lines should show that status as a binary ones. So if it is if you are reading these four bits, return lines four bits status as a binary ones, then definitely there is no key pressed on the keyboard. We are having the hardware factors which we are supposed to consider. I'm going to define them first. First of all, let us see how exactly the pressed key is going to be recognized by the microcontroller so that we can write the program very easily. Okay, now. So here, the programming concept I'm not going to explain over here in this case. So here, no key is pressed on the keyboard. So obviously, there is no contact between the columns as well as the rows. When there is no contact between the columns as well as the rows, then obviously the the return lines which are acting as means higher nibble of the port B is acting as the return lines. Now those lines status is going to be the binary ones. Let us suppose a key is pressed on the keyboard. For example, I am taking the 9. Okay, assume that I pressed the key number 9, which is assigned with the digit 9. Okay. So when you are pressing this particular 9th key, obviously there is a contact between the, if at all I am assuming it is a 0 column, column 0, column 1, column 2, there is a contact between the column 0 and if I am assuming this one is a, row 0, row 1, row 2, then it is obviously third column, second row. Okay, it is going to be the third column and the second row. Okay, so it is the second row now. So obviously when this key has been pressed, then this particular column bit position is going to be read as a 0. Means what we are expecting, that the input status of these four lines should be the ones. If at all any one of the line position is not read as a 1, it is a 0, then definitely there is a key pressed on the keyboard. Okay, so in this case, When I'm pressing the 9th key, obviously there's a contact between this column and this row. So that's why it is going to be read as a 0, because we are making this bit as a, we made this particular line as a output line. So this 0 is going to be driven as an input to this particular line. So obviously the input lines means the return line status is going to be get disturbed. What we are expecting? 4 ones. But as there is a key pressed on the keyboard, then the input is not going to be the 4 ones. It is going to be three bits are going to be the ones and another bit is going to be the 0. So now what we are supposed to do, we are supposed to trace out which key has been pressed on the keyboard. Okay, now. So as there is a change in the status of the return lines, then what we are going to do means we are going to move in order to figure out which key has been pressed on the keyboard, we are having some methods. What we are going to do means we are going to make these bits as the ones and we are going to take the present status of these particular return lines and we are going to make the first row as a 0 and the rest of the rows as a ones. We are going to make the first row as a 0 and the rest of the rows are going to be the ones, binary ones. So if I'm making the first one as a 0 and the rest as a ones, first one as a 0 and rest as a, first one as a 0, rest as a ones, then is there any key pressure on this particular row? No. So as there is no key pressure on this particular row, obviously the output is going to be read as a 4 ones. Obviously the output is going to be read as a 4 ones. Means there no key has been pressed on this particular row. Okay. In the next case, what we are going to do means we are going to make this particular row as a 1, this one as a 0, this one as a 1, and this one as a 1. At that time, again, we are reading the present status of the, return values. So obviously we pressed the 9th key now. So because of that, during the second row, means when we made the second row as a 0 and the rest of the rows as a 1s, then obviously we are going to get the altered value. Means it is going to be, it is not going to be the 4 ones, it is going to be some, means 1 1 0 1 combination. We are going to read this one as a, 1 1 0 1 combination. When you are reading this one as a 1 1 0 1 combination, 1 1 0 1 combination, and this one is a 0, okay now. So this one is a 0 and 1 1 0 combination, we are reading it over here now. So it is going to be pointed out as like this. Okay, now the ninth key has been, so whenever you are getting the keyword like, whenever you are making the rows as a 1 0 1 1, and at the output you are getting the changed lines. It is not the binary one, something is missing. So at that time we are going to have some binary combination to identify that it is a number 9. That combination we are going to see that one. Okay. So like that, the microcontroller is going to be recognized the pressed key on the keyboard. Means it is a purely depends on the developer to write the program in the proper way. Otherwise, the pressed key is not going to be recognized properly by the microcontroller. So it is the responsibility of the developer to write the program in the proper way. Okay. So in short, if you are not getting this entire explanation, in short, we can say that using this particular keyword combination, in short, we can say that whenever the scan lines, those are nothing but RB3 to RB0. So we are making the RB3 as a 0 now. So means the first row is going to be the 0 and the rest of the rows are going to be 1. Then the possibilities which key has been pressed on this keyboard means, let us come back to the diagram. Okay, now over here. So if the first row is a 0, this particular row is a 0 and rest of them are 1, then which key would have been pressed if at all you are reading the status of the return lines as a 0, one of the return line as a 0, then there might be a chance of the pressed key might be 0, 4, 8 or C. Okay. So if at all you are making this particular row as a 1 and this one is a 0 and a 1-1 combination and you are getting some altered value on the return lines, then the pressed key, one of the pressed key might be the digits which are there on this particular row. Similar to that, the digits which are particular on this particular row, the digits which are pressed on this particular row. So this is a direct approach to realize the concept. But in my concept, what I'm going to do is I'm briefly explaining that how the microcontroller is going to be recognized. In that format only, we are supposed to write the program so that the microcontroller is going to be recognized the pressed key. What is the approach? First, we are configuring the return lines as a ones, means the as a inputs, scan lines as an outputs. So if at all something has been pressed on the keyboard, return lines, one of the return lines status is going to be the 0. Why it is a 0? Because the column and the row is making some contact. Because of that, as the row is made as a 0, this particular 0 is driven as an input to the return lines. So obviously we are getting the we are expecting 4 ones, but there is a change. When there is a key pressure on this particular keyboard, obviously this particular one of the bit position is going to be the 0. So at that time the approach is what? First, what we are doing, focusing on these lines, and we are making the first row as a 0 and the rest of them as a 1s. If at all there is no change in the return lines, then obviously there is no key pressure on this particular row. As we don't have the board, it is very difficult to explain, but we have seen this explanation in the classroom, so that's why I'm just giving a brief. Okay, so if it is a 0 and rest of them are the 1, but the when you are making like this, then the return lines are going to be all 1s. When the return lines are all 1s, obviously no key has been pressed on this particular row. So the next case is I'm going to make the second row as a 0 and the first row, next two rows are going to be the 1. Then obviously one of the return line is showing it as a, 2. One of the return line is showing it as a 0. Then obviously there is a key pressed on this particular row. Now identifying the key is nothing but we are fixing on that particular return line and we are focusing on the which key has been which row has been made as a zero. So based on this particular bit combination, we can finalize that which key has been pressed on the keyboard. So look at this one. So we pressed the ninth pin now. So what we are going to do is we are making the first row as a zero, first row as a one, next row as a zero, and the rest of them as a ones. Then obviously the output is going to be, if at all we are reading the output from the return lines, if at all we are reading the return line status as a 1101, we are writing the binary, what is that, a group of statements to shift this value, rotate this value and identify which key has been pressed. That's the programming part. But the thing is, if you are having the scan line status as a 1011 and if you are reading the return line status as a 1101, then definitely this pressed key is going to be the 9. So in brief, but if, when you are going for writing the program, we are performing the shifting operation on the return lines so that which key has been pressed on the keyboard, that one is going to be identified. We are performing the shifting operation when you are going to write the program. But in brief, in if you want to know that one, simple thing is, if the scan lines combination is a 1011 and the return combination is a 1101, then definitely the press key is going to be the 9. So here, in this way, in the first row, if at all the first row is a 0 and if the return line status is a 0111, then the press key is a 0. 1011, then the press key is going to be the 1. 1101, then the press key is going to be the 8. And 1110, press key is going to be the C. It is not that much easy, you know, what you are seeing on the table when you are going to write the program. Again, I am saying, what we are going to do is, we are going to hook up on the scan lines and we are shifting the return line status. We are hooking on the scan lines, we are shifting the return line status to identify which return line is read as a 0. Which return line is read as a 0 with help of the ZZ instruction, jump on 0, jump on 0 combination. Based on that only, we are going to identify this particular press key on that particular row. Okay, so this is the way. For the first row, what is that, the digits might be 048C, and the second row digits might be 159D. So obviously, from the schema, this table is prepared from the interfacing diagram only. I'm not going back to the diagram again. So here, the next combination is, for the second row, it is going to be the 1101. These are acting as a scan lines, and these are acting as a return lines. So this table is there in your material which I sent you. You just go through that material. If you are having the, I think some of you people are having the, the microcontroller by Ajay Deshmukh textbook. Okay, now don't say that we don't have, but you are having that particular textbook, because we discussed the third unit. Obviously, some of you would have taken the textbook from the librarian. So if you are having the this textbook, what you do is share this particular textbook pages with your friends in the WhatsApp group. Okay, now use the CAM scanner. With the help of the CAM scanner, you can prepare the PDF file and send that PDF file to the to your friends, whoever are not having that particular microcontroller textbook. It is your responsibility. I'm not going to do anything, right? Because we don't have the I don't have the textbook right now with me, but I sent what I'm having with me to you people using the through the particular group. Okay, so this is the way. For the third row, if it is the 1101 combination, the press key might be the 0111 1101 1110. Okay, now. So like this, we are having the last row also. Okay, we are having the last row also. Okay, now let's go back to concentrate on some of the points on this particular keyboard. Some of the points related to the keyboard. Okay. So the points are a very simple one. Here we are using the keyboard now, which the keys are arranged. Keys are nothing but the push buttons. In simple cases, the push buttons. Okay. So we know that sometimes, I think you would have come across this particular scenario in when you are typing something on the personal computer. So you are typing something on the keyboard, but sometimes it is not going to be recognized by the personal computer. Even though you press the key, a particular key, in the proper way, but it is not going to be recognized by the microcontroller, that is your personal computer. That's why it is not printing on the screen. Now the question comes up, why it is not getting printed on the on that particular screen is a question. First point might be, you would have not pressed the key with a minimum amount of delay. Means, if you are not pressing a particular key on the keyboard for a minimum of 20 milliseconds. For a minimum of 20 milliseconds, then definitely it is not going to be recognized by the micro, that is a personal controller or the microcontroller matrix keyboard. If you want, allow the personal computer to print your presser key on the screen, then you are supposed to hold that particular key for a minimum of 20 milliseconds duration. For a minimum of 20 milliseconds durations. Let us suppose I pressed the key, I pressed a particular key very fastly. Assume that it is taking the 10 microseconds only. Then definitely your key is not going to be recognized by the personal computer. Okay, now, so that delay value purely depends on the which type of what is that keyboard we are interfacing to the personal computer. So the minimum thing is a 20 milliseconds duration. If you are not pressing that, means if you are not pressing that particular keyboard and holding that particular key for a minimum of 20 milliseconds duration, then definitely your presser key is not going to be recognized by your microcontroller. Presser key is not going to be recognized by your microcontroller. And another case is debouncing noise connections. Keyboard keys debouncing noise connections means we are having this one. Key debounce. Okay. Key debounce means when you are taking the key, when you are pressing a key on the keyboard, then definitely that key may or may not make in the contact, so what is that, continuously. Means there is a, you are pressing the key on the keyboard for a 20 microseconds duration, even though you press the key on the keyboard for a minimum of 20 microseconds duration, it is not going to be get recognized by the microcontroller sometimes. It is just because of noise. Noise is nothing but you are pressing the key and that pressed key is touching the PCB, touches and loses. Means there is no proper contact between the pressed key and the PCB, which is there under that particular button. Then definitely that pressed key is not going to be recognized by the microcontroller as a key. Okay. So as a pressed digit. Okay. So in order to avoid that one particular one, it is all just because of the keyboard, key debouncing operation. Means you are pressing, but it is not touching the PCB continuously. There might be a, means contact disconnect, connection disconnection. It is going to be done inside the, between the, push button and the PCB. Okay, so because of that, there is a noise. That noise is going to be, means that noise is going to be disturbs the microcontroller to in recognizing the pressed key. So to overcome that particular debouncing problem, we are going with the one RC component circuit. Means we are using the, we are interfacing this particular key, push button on the keyboard. We are installing this particular push button on the keyboard along with the resistors, capacitor, followed by the switch trigger. If you are using this entire setup along with the push button, then definitely we are going to avoid the key debouncing problem. Remember, one thing is key debounce is nothing but making the contact and connection and disconnection. So it might be, means if the contact between, when you are pressing the key on the keyboard, if that particular push button is not making the contact with the PCB properly, then definitely it is going to be treated as a noise, which is going to be affects the actual process. Means because of that particular miscontact. It is not a miscontact, it is a contact only, but it is not get recognized by the controller. Then definitely it is going to be the error. To overcome that one, we are having the this kind of structure. Means each and every key which is there on the keyboard should follow this particular configuration. Resistor, capacitor along with the switch. So using this way, we can avoid the debouncing concept. And another way is, as I said, if you want to get, allow the microcontroller to recognize the pressed key on the keyboard, then definitely you should hold that particular pressed key for a minimum of 20 microseconds. If it is not hold for a minimum of 20 microseconds, then definitely it is not going to get recognized by the microcontroller. Because the microcontroller, when you are pressing the keyboard on the, when you are pressing the key on the keyboard, definitely what the microcontroller need to do, first it need to concentrate, keep on concentrate on the return lines. If at all there is a change in the return line status, then it has to identify the pressed key on the keyboard by concentrating on the scan lines. Means first we are having the four scan lines now. First, in order to identify the pressed key, as we have seen, first we are focusing on the return lines. and first row, your first scan line is going to be made as a 0, rest of the scan lines are going to be 1s. Okay, now, so if at all the return line status is same, then obviously the pressure key is not there on the first row. Then what we are supposed to do, next approach is, again the first row should be made as a 1, second row should be the 0, and the next coming two rows should also be made as a 1s. So at that time, if we are getting any change in the return lines, then there might be some key pressure on that particular row. If it is not, again, the first row, second row should be made as a 1, and third row should be made as a 0, and the fourth row should be made as a 1. Those are the scan lines, and again concentrate on the return lines. So to do this entire operation, microprocessor needs some time to check which key has been pressed in software approach, especially in software approach. So that's why you should hold your pressed key on the keyboard for a minimum of 20 milliseconds delay. It is not the microseconds, it is a 20 milliseconds delay. Okay, so this is all about our interfacing the keyboard to the microcontroller. It is interfacing the keyboard to the microcontroller. So if you want, you can go with the program. I think all of you are not having that much of knowledge on the PIC instruction set. Then you can easily write your own program in 8051 case. I think I would have explained this particular program in the third semester. If not, what you do is let me know. Send a message in the WhatsApp group so that we are going to see the the program. Means how to write the program when we are interfacing the Matrix keyboard directly to the microcontroller, which is a software approach. Okay, you can write the program. It is very easy, but before going to that, you should realize the concept. Concept is, in brief again, let me explain. So when you are trying to interface your Matrix keyboard to the microcontroller, so we are dividing the Matrix keyboard is having the columns and the rows lines. Columns and the rows. So we are treating the row of columns as a return lines, which are nothing but the input lines, and scan lines are rows as a, we are treating the rows as a scan lines, which are nothing but the output lines. These are acting as a return lines, means input lines. These are acting as a output lines. Whenever something has been pressed on the keyboard, in some cases, let us suppose no key pressed on the keyboard. If no key pressed on the keyboard, we already configured these lines, four lines as a output lines, and these four lines as the input lines. Now, obviously, these we are keep on reading the present status of the input lines. Now, so these input lines read as a binary ones. But as I said, in order to configure the port to pin direction as the input pin or output pin, we are supposed to focus on the direction control register. Again, I'm repeating that one. It is not the case, means direction control registers are not there in the 8051, but in the PIC microcontroller, if you want to configure one of the port line as a input line or the output line, you should focus on the direction control register of the respective port. Okay, so it is our responsibility to write the respective port bit as a 1 or 0. If you are writing a 1, then you are making that particular pin as a input pin. And if you are writing a 0, you are making that particular pin as a output line. Okay. So here, I am writing the binary 1s on the higher level of the direction control register of the port B, which is nothing but the TRISB. And I am writing the lower level of the port B in the TRISB register as a 0s. So that's why they are configured as a output lines. If something is pressed on the keyboard, then definitely the input lines, that is the return lines, are going to be are not going to have the 4 1s. There is a change in the previous status. Means every time the present status of the return lines compared with the previous status, present status compared with the previous status. Whenever there is a change between the present and the previous status, obviously something has been pressed on the keyboard. For that, in order to identify the pressed key, the procedure is, in one order, we are making the one of the port as a output port, one of the port line as an output line, and the rest as a input lines. So I said it as a 0111, 1011, 1101, 1110. I said like that. But other way of explanation is making the input output lines. Okay. So means we are simply concentrating on the scan lines. Make one of the scan line as a 0. Check the compare the present status of this particular return lines with the previous line. If there is no change, obviously there is no key pressure on this particular line. make the second scan line as a zero and the rest of the scan lines as a ones, and read the present stress of the return line. If the present stress of the return line is what is that? There is no change in the present status of the return lines with respect to the previous status, then obviously no key has been pressed on the second row. So the next case is make this particular third row as a zero and the rest of the rows as a ones. Then if you are getting any change in the return lines case, means the present status of the return lines is changing with respect to the previous status, obviously something has been pressed on that particular third row. Okay, so like that the specific key is going to be identified and displayed on the screen. Okay, so this is the way of interfacing the keyboard, matrix keyboard, to the microcontroller using the software approach. It is not the hardware approach. If we are having the hardware approach, it is the responsibility of the 8279, not the responsibility of the microcontroller. What is the drawback of this particular software approach? Every time the microcontroller need to keep on monitor the return lines. If at all we are using the hardware approach like 8279, the 8279 is the one which is going to be takes this particular scanning and retaining operation and identifies the pressed key, stores that information, gives that information to the microcontroller by interrupting the microcontroller. So that is the easy way. But the problem with the hardware approach is the cost of the system may be increases. As you are integrating one more IC, then the space occupied by the system may going to be increases. So there are do's and don'ts. Depending on our requirement, we may use the hardware approach in interfacing the matrix keyboard to the microcontroller, or we may use the software approach. But the software approach problem is, it is a very difficult problem because the microcontroller need to be focused on the return lines continuously. So one more point is also there. Let me take that explanation also. I'll take the 5 more minutes. We have one type of interrupt. Have you remembered or not? I don't know. Change on interrupt. Port B. Change on interrupt. Port B. Change on interrupt. We are having the three interrupts in 6-1 family. In 7-1 family, we are having the four interrupts, right? In 6-1 family, 16C61, we are having the three interrupts. 16C71, we are having the four interrupts. In 16F877, how many interrupts are there? Answer yourself. Okay, so one of the interrupt is a port to be change interrupt. So if you are enabling that particular interrupt a bit in the INT CON register, interrupt control register, if you would have enabled that particular interrupt in the INT CON register, then no need to allow the microcontroller to keep on monitor the present status of the port to be, because we have one interrupt called as a port to be change interrupt. Again, I'm saying that one, we have studied that particular feature. Okay, so port to be change means whenever there is a change on the higher order nibble of the port to be, then one interrupt is going to be generated to the microcontroller. This feature is there in the 16C61, 71, 16F877 also. Okay, now, so that's why we are using the port to be over here in interfacing the matrix keyboard to the microcontroller. So port to be change interrupt is nothing but whenever there is a change in the higher nibble of the port to be, then definitely one interrupt is going to be generated to the microcontroller. So by using that interrupt concept, we can allow the microcontroller to do some other tasks if at all no key has been pressed on the keyboard. Because we made this one as a once now, we made this the higher nibble as a once now. If at all there is a change, obviously there is an interrupt is generated to the microcontroller. If there is no change, no interrupt is generated to the microcontroller. So obviously no key has been pressed on the keyboard. So here we can make use of the interrupt concept by concentrating on the RBP0. Okay, now port B lines. So using that particular RBP0 along with the INT CON register, you can enable the you can enable the interrupt related to the port to be change interrupt. Okay, now, right? So this is the case. So software approach. Here in the software approach, we are using the interrupt. Let us suppose we don't have the interrupt option. Then obviously, when you are using the software approach in interfacing the keyboard to the microcontroller, then there's a little bit problem to the microcontroller, because every time microcontroller need to be keep on check the present status of the return lines. So another way is we can avoid this one, either using the interrupt concept like this one, Other one case is we are having the hardware approach, which is a 8 to 7. But there are do's and don'ts. Depending on our requirement, we are going to choose the appropriate approach. Okay. So that's all for now regarding the keyboard interfacing to the microcontroller. If you are having any queries, you can message me in the WhatsApp group. And one more thing is, some of you are having the microcontroller textbook. I know that one, right? Because we took the textbook from the library. Okay. So some of you are having the textbook on microcontroller topics. Means for microcontroller, you took the textbook. I know that one. So what you do is you share that particular material information, the textbook pages, with with your friends, whoever is not having that textbook. Okay. That's all for now. If you are having any queries, again, you can send the post us your queries in the WhatsApp.